Yo, what is up, Buttercups? Welcome back to another video, and yes, I know it's been such a long time since we had some good news. Season 13 has started, and there are a lot of changes that we might not know about. So what I'm going to do in this video is I'm going to read patch notes to you. If you're new to the channel, make sure to like and subscribe, hit that bell for post notifications. We're just gonna get into it. I'm looking right here at charlieintel.com. They did a pretty good job at listing out the patch notes. So if we go winter patch notes, what's new? Call of Duty Mobile 13, new functional weapons, operators, score streaks, new map. Let's go, Russia raid. Holiday is back, new multiplayer mode, and much more. All right, so here's some stuff about the Battle Pass. I'm not going to focus too much on Battle Pass. Let's get to that later. What I am really interested in are the multiplayer changes. These changes are what will make or break this game. Quite literally. Here we go. Improvements and optimizations. Multiplayer. Check this out. Increase ammo amount for death machine. So fire rate will gradually increase. Huh. Okay, so this will actually make it more viable. As it is right now, no one uses death machine. Why? Because it's just not good enough. Significantly increase ammo amount for equalizer. Okay, wait, hold on. You're telling me that basically you're adding more ammo to the perk that gives you an akimbo fennec feel? Almost plus speed? Okay, bro. I haven't really seen the equalizer. Maybe this will allow people to use it more? Decrease annihilator bullet tracking range. That's a big one. The Annihilator is and might still be the best operator skill to use because it locks on, but now it looks like it will be harder to use due to shrinkage of tracking range. We'll see how that changes throughout the season and how many people continue to use it throughout the season. Decrease ballistic shields, pistol ammo amount. Okay, I actually played a couple games using the ballistic shield and you run out of ammo so quick. Okay, woo, changes to the Fennec, let's go. Slightly decrease Fennec, MIP barrel, and no stock movement speed. Wow, that's a big change. All right, slightly decrease of the Fennec's reload speed when you're using akimbo. That's a huge change right there. Okay, slightly decrease Fennec akimbo damage. That's an even bigger change. Wow, they actually listened to the community. Slightly decrease Arctic 50 stopping power rounds, recoil control, and ammo count. So I have heard a lot of this, like the Arctic 50 is a little bit too broken for sniper rifles, mainly because the ADS time is so quick and the constant rate of fire. Decreased HVK 30s, large caliber ammo mid-range damage. That is a huge nerf. If you didn't know, the HVK had a mid-range from like 20 meters to like 60 meters where you could four tap people no matter the range. The damage was insanely good. That's why it was like the number one recommended gun for mid-range and long range by pros. I mean, it was everywhere. Sniper rifles and marksman rifle now have a short period of steady aiming sight after ADS. I think what this means is that if you're looking into a scope for a small amount of time, you're steady and then you start to move around, sort of. Decreased recoil control for MYK, integral suppressor, light barrel for ICR, LK, and RUS, and chicken. Wow. Okay, so you get more recoil now. Players can now see which targets blocked by roof on predator missile camera screen. Cryo bombs thrown to Molotov burning area will be destroyed. Okay. Molotov cocktails thrown to cryo bomb freezing area will be destroyed. Okay, I guess that makes sense. But if you didn't know this, and I didn't know this until today, you can actually shoot a cryo bomb to destroy it, which is actually pretty cool. I didn't know that. Trip mines now can only be triggered by touching the laser. Wow, so you have to be, I guess that you have to be more precise now? Annihilator no longer tracks players using ballistic shield from the front. Okay, I didn't know that was a big problem. Flak jacket perk can now reduce Molotov and thermite damage. Okay, cool. Dead silent perks only takes effect when people are walking, squat walking, and crawling. Okay, whoa. This is the biggest nerf to a perk I have ever seen. This might actually make it so where dead silence is useless. Right now, Call of Duty Mobile is a very rush-heavy game. Every now and then, you have your campers out there in crossfires. Yeah, you know, just hide behind the wall. Oh, look, he's right there. Hardscope, boom. Nah, this one makes it so you can hear people sneaking up on you. This is a game changer. Wow, that is crazy. High quality ranked matches now have unique icons in personnel history page. What? That's a weird one. I don't know what that means. Attachment advantage and disadvantage now show specific stats in gunsmith, which is a plus. Thank you. Optimized FPP running animation. Thank you. Also, optimized gun switching logic, switching Guns while running will no longer slow a player down. I didn't even know that was a thing. Optimized position speeds between standing, squatting, and lying down. Okay, that's pretty cool. Optimized display of reaction skin weapons. Is that like the movement skins? Okay, this one's a mouthful. Optimized upgrade experience details of mythic weapons and added guidance? Huh? Okay, optimized mythic weapon awards. Okay, that's pretty cool. Optimized matching algorithm for multiplayer rank mode. Okay, so we're getting optimized, supposedly optimized. Players in single game will have similar skill levels. Okay, so this is the problem. Everyone is going to get in legendary within the first week. How does this actually help those of us who are way better than 80% of the people who will go legendary? You know, I get tired of going 20 and 12 and then have three people on my team go triple negative. Optimizing ranking point calculation rules for domination hardpoint. Okay, that might be interesting. Participating and taking holding points now offers high end ranking points. Okay, so now it makes you want to play objective. Okay, which is cool. Optimized matchmaking algorithm narrowed the level gap between players in a single game. Okay, here's the thing. How do you optimize when everyone's already in legendary? I get it in master, where you get paired up with like a master 1 and a master 3, and you don't want to get paired up with a master 1 if you're a master 5 or a legendary. Okay, so this is where I'm going to keep an eye on. Are they going to do it based on how many points you get from legendary? Like if you're like hit that 6,500 point, whatever it is, which gets you to legendary, are you going to stop pairing up with 20,000, you know, those grinders that are trying to grind on the leaderboard? Okay, that's a pretty good question to ask. It's a lot of stuff for BR, general fixes, so that, guys, alright, let me know in the comments if you want me to go over the BR stuff, alright? I personally haven't played as much BR as I should have, but if you're interested in that kind of stuff, let me know. Guys, alright, that's going to be it for this video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit that bell for post notifications. So let me know what you thought in the comments. Guys, as always, thank you so much. I love y'all. Stay warm. I'll catch y'all next one. Bye!